So YouTube, team, keep it clean. Before we get into this video, I got to give a special shout out to Rob Fuse, to Rob McCall, and to Dominique Henson. Now, the three of them, they're Ravens fans who unfortunately over the past couple of weeks, they each lost somebody very close to them. Robert Fuse this morning, he lost his fiance. Robert McCall, he lost his mom. And Dominique Henson, he lost one of his brothers. So it's a very... It's super unfortunate, man. It's a very unfortunate circumstance when you lose somebody that you love, when you lose somebody that's close to you. And it's probably like one of the worst parts of life, man, because it's painful. But we want y'all to know that we all rocking with y'all. We rooting for y'all. Make sure you keep your heads up, keep pushing, keep going. And just don't stop. Don't stop. Now, take some time for yourself now. Take some time for yourself to sort of take a step back from everything. Take a breather and just really reflect on everything. Reflect on all the positive times that you had with the ones that you lost. And just keep trying to be positive about things, man. And be there for your family, too. Be there for your friends and your family and whatnot. And just be there for other people, and they'll be there for you, too. We all here for y'all, and we want y'all to know that we love y'all, we appreciate y'all, and it takes a lot of strength for y'all to even be willing to share those personal aspects of your lives with everybody. So feel free to reach out whenever, and know that, again, we got y'all. So, team, keep it clean. Sort of transitioning to this move with the Baltimore Ravens. They're signing Javon Swan. Javon Swan, he's an undrafted rookie free agent. It says that he went to rookie camp with the Pittsburgh Steelers, but that obviously didn't work itself out. He worked out for the Texans, and that didn't work out. But the Baltimore Ravens, they like what they see, and they decided to make it official and make that move and bring him on to the squad. Now, I looked him up. I see, he did go to Indiana, and like it was brought out, he went to Stanford as well. He's been playing. He's an interior defensive lineman. His numbers, they're not eye-popping or anything like that, but at the same time, interior defensive linemen, they don't get eye-popping numbers. Well, unless it's Aaron Donald. But besides Aaron Donald, they don't get these eye-popping stats and a bunch of tackles and a bunch of sacks, anything like that, because they do a lot of the dirty work. And the linebackers and the outside linebackers, the defensive ends, they're usually the ones that get the pretty numbers. Like the linebackers, they get a bunch of the tackles. The defensive end and the outside linebackers, they get a bunch of the sacks. But the interior defensive linemen, they do a lot of dirty work that goes unappreciated. So one of the reasons why they're signing him is because they just lost last week, toward the end of last week, Xavier Kelly, another undrafted rookie free agent. They lost him to an Achilles injury. So his season is unfortunately over before it even got started. And that's what I always say is the worst part about football is injuries, because every team goes through them. A lot of players go through them, and it can not only change a game, not only change a season, but they can change careers. Because it could be a guy on the brink of getting his shot. He's looking good, performing well. Then all of a sudden he gets hurt and things aren't the same ever again. So we'll see how it all works itself out with Xavier Kelly. Now, what he is a candidate for, and what's most likely going to happen, like 9.9 times out of 10, is that the Ravens waive him and then he clears waivers and then he reverts back to the Ravens. And then they can put him on injured reserve. So he'll be with them for the remainder of this season. And then he'll be able to give it a shot next year. It's a very similar story to Jacob Breland, the tight end from, did he go to Oregon? I want to say he went to Oregon. But Jacob Breland from last year. He's a tight end who the Ravens signed, but he was hurt when they signed him. But obviously they like what they saw, so they still signed him anyway, and they wanted to keep him around. They waived him. He cleared waivers. He reverted back to the Ravens, and he went on injured reserve. So that's why he's still with the Ravens now. So we'll see what happens with him, too. Now, the Ravens, they did announce, it was announced about maybe 20, 30 minutes ago that they had also brought in another defensive lineman, Darius Kilgo. They worked out Darius Kilgo. And he, because I looked up a little bit on him, and he's actually an NFL veteran, though. He's a veteran. He spent some time with the Lions. He spent some time with the Broncos and spent some time with the Titans as well. But over the past 2 years, he didn't look like he got any playing time. I'm not sure if he was on the practice squad or not, but the Ravens also brought him in. Now, I believe their roster size right now is at about 89 or 90. With this move, it puts it at either 89 or 90. I forget. It's around there. So they pretty much got a full roster. And they, who knows, they may end up signing him as well. But the Ravens right now, for OTAs and everything, they had a shortage of defensive linemen because their main guys, the guys who are expected to make the roster, like a Calais Campbell, Brandon Williams, Derek Wolfe, and Justin Ellis, those guys weren't at OTAs. And no, it's not concerning anything like that. It's not like, oh my goodness, where were they at? Why didn't they show up? It was voluntary, so they didn't have to be there. Even though I know a lot of y'all talked about it, they said, hey man, I remember when I was playing football, my coach, when he said voluntary, that really meant you need to show up. But in the NFL, it's obviously a bit different. But with those guys not being at OTAs, then there's a shortage of interior defensive linemen. And just because you have a shortage, it doesn't mean like you're going to, oh, okay, we ain't got no defensive linemen. We don't want to skip that drill. You still want to get the guys who may not be starters or may not even be expected to make the team. You still want to get those guys some work because you still have a, you had an Xavier Kelly, but you also had a guy like Broderick Washington. And I'm sure he's been taking up every single opportunity that he possibly can, especially with the guys that are all in front of him being out. You got to take advantage of those opportunities. You have to because, yeah, the Ravens are watching you and you really fighting for a roster spot. But then it's a possibility that other teams are watching, too. And the Ravens could put in a word for you and be like, hey, we got a lot of defensive linemen. But this guy right here, he's really good. We know he's going to be a stud, but all he needs is playing time. We can't offer that to him right now. And the way that our numbers game matches up right now, it's not going to work out. So they could end up putting in a good word for you, and whether they release somebody or waive somebody or they traded somebody to a different team, that could really set you up for the future. So it's very important that as a backup, you take full advantage of every single opportunity that you possibly can. So we'll see how this entire situation works itself out. Anyway, Dominic, Robert, and Rob, we all rocking with y'all, man. Keep your heads up. And like I said, do not feel afraid to reach out. Feel free to reach out whenever. Whenever. Team Keep It Clean is rocking with y'all. We love y'all. Appreciate y'all. Keep spreading positivity, man. We out.